بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to the daily short reminders. Insha'Allah, today we will learn another beautiful teaching of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and listen to an amazing story. Before we get there, I would just like you to make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts everyone's efforts who try to make these daily short reminders. And second thing, please subscribe to our channel and turn on the notification button. So as soon as our next daily reminder comes out, you can get it straight away. Jazakumullahu khair. Dear children, the beautiful teaching of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is, there is wisdom, something really special behind everything Allah Ta'ala does. And we should be happy with it, just like how Allah Ta'ala has done it or made it. So if Allah has made us short, we shouldn't complain that why am I so short for? Why has Allah made me short? No, dear children, there is wisdom behind it why Allah has made you short. Or if Allah has made you really tall, then you shouldn't complain that why am I so tall for? Everyone makes fun of me. Or why do I have really dark skin? Or why do I have really fair skin? Dear children, these things we should not complain about. Rather, we should thank Allah because there's always hidden wisdom behind it. In the time of Sayyiduna Musa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, he was a great prophet of Allah. So one day, a person came to him and he said, O Musa alayhi salam, make dua for me that I am able to talk to animals. Now, dear children, just imagine if we had the ability to talk to animals, how amazing would it be? We would be able to talk to our cats and we would be able to talk to the birds flying in the sky. So this person also thought it would be an amazing thing that I can talk to animals. So he went to Musa alayhi salam asking him to make dua that he is able to talk to animals. Musa alayhi salam told him, Allah has not given the human beings the ability to talk to animals. There is wisdom behind it. So don't ask Allah to give you the ability to talk to animals. But this person, he was not ready to listen. He kept on asking and asking and asking. Finally, Musa alayhi salam said to him, if I make dua to Allah that he gives you the ability to talk to animals, then all of the bad which happens to you will be your fault. The person, he did not understand what Musa alayhi salam meant, that if something happens wrong to you. So he happily agreed, saying, okay, I am more than happy with it. So Musa alayhi salam made dua for him and he was able to talk to and listen to animals now. Really happy with this superpower of his, he wanted to go and test it out. When he reached home, he saw that his dog is barking and his chicken is clucking. He was really happy that now he will be able to test out his superpower. So he went next to them and he started listening. The dog was complaining that you have taken my food away. How can you take the bread which the servant threw out of the house and leave me to starve? The chicken replied, do not worry. Tomorrow our owner's horse will die and You can have all the meat you want. And because I cannot have meat, so let me enjoy this bread. This person got really worried and sold his horse. Exactly how the chicken said. The horse died the next day. But he was very lucky because he was able to save all that money, which would have gone to waste if the horse had died at his house. But the dog was very unlucky. He remained hungry for another day. So the dog went and complained to the chicken, saying, "Where is the dead horse? You promised me yesterday." The chicken replied, "The horse did die, but our owner sold the horse before it died. But, oh dog, do not worry. Tomorrow, the donkey of our owner will die, and you can have all the meat you want." The dog became really happy, but with this new information, the owner went and sold his donkey as well. Saving a lot of money, he was really happy, but the dog, he was really hungry because today was the third day that he did not have food. He went to the chicken and complained that, "Where is the dead donkey? You promised." The chicken replied, "Yes, the donkey did die, but our owner sold the donkey before it died. That's why you did not get any meat." The dog was really hungry and tired. So he asked the chicken, "When will I get food?" The chicken replied, "Oh dog, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sends down small problems to save a person from bigger problems. Allah was taking the life of the horse, so our owner has a bit of problem. But our owner, because he can understand the language of the animals, he heard us and saved himself a lot of money by selling his horse before it died. Then Allah gave him a second chance. But again, he sold the donkey and saved himself from losing out on a lot of money. So now Allah will send down the big problem, because first he was sending down small problems to protect him from big problem, but he pushed away the small problems. So now Allah will send down a big problem, and when that big problem comes down, you can have all the meat you want." The dog asked, "What is that big problem?" The chicken replied, "It is the death of our owner. Tomorrow, our owner, he will die. And when he dies, people will come from all over. A lot of food will be prepared, so you can have all the food you want." When the owner listened to this, he got really scared. He went to Musa alayhi salam and he told him the whole story. And he was crying and saying, "Oh Musa alayhi salam, can you please ask Allah to forgive me for my ignorance and save me from death? I do not want to die. I wish I never asked to be able to understand the animals and talk to the animals." Musa alayhi salam replied, "Well, now it's too late. You will have to suffer the punishment." So dear children, behind everything, there's always the wisdom of Allah. We should be happy with it, because if we were slightly different, who knows how many problems we would have to face. So we should thank Allah for whatever He has done and however He is doing it. I hope you enjoyed listening to this beautiful story. Till next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.